Okay, welcome to the last of our videos for the National Seafood Month. My name is Matt Thompson. I'm the Aquaculture Project Lead for the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life. And I'm here with Lena Weiss and Michelle Cho. And they are our wild fisheries specialists for our program. For this video, we wanted to talk about actions that you can take to help support a vital and vibrant ocean and that will really make a difference. And number one, the most important thing you can do is to buy seafood from a company, a restaurant or a retailer with a dedicated and public commitment to sustainable seafood. You can find these potentially on the company's website or on a poster in the restaurant itself or on the menu, or you can even ask the wait staff if they have a sustainable seafood policy. So the next one is to raise questions at the point of sale. And these can be asking questions like, where is your seafood from and how's it caught? And number three would be to get out and vote, to consider ocean issues in your day-to-day life and factor that into your decision-making when you're going out and you're making decisions about who to vote for. Okay, so why do we recommend looking to see if the seafood company has a stated sustainable seafood policy? Well, these are probably one of the most important documents that show A, that the company is aware of the issue. So maybe that policy will state a recognition of how important sustainable seafood is. Secondly, what it does is it articulates what that company is going to do about sustainable seafood. So they may have made firm commitments to source seafood that only has a certain certification, or in some cases comes from an improvement project that's trying to advance sustainability. There are other components that they might do around policy and social issues. Sometimes sustainable seafood policies cover a wide range of things like packaging as well as the sourcing of raw material. Some key things to think about when it comes to sustainable seafood policies is that they're reflective of the sort of nature of the company. So often they'll set levels that are relevant to maybe the price point of the products that they sell or the repertoire of seafoods that they have available to them. So this is why when you look at sustainable seafood policies, they can differ from one to another. The aquarium is partnered with some of the largest players in the seafood industry, including Gortons of Gloucester, who we've had a partnership for the last 10 years, to establish a really well-defined policy. So what you really need to do is to look for a policy that is well defined. So it's not making vague statements about what it's going to do. The strongest policies clearly articulate things like a commitment to meet certain goals by a certain amount of time and to utilize some of these tools in their toolbox like certifications. Michelle, you're going to talk about number two?
Yeah, so thanks. If you guys have been tuning in since the first video, thanks so much for sticking with us. And if this is your first time, thanks for joining us, and thanks for your interest in sustainable seafood. So like Matt said, you can ask a lot of questions when you're buying your seafood or ordering your seafood at a restaurant. And these questions can be about where your seafood comes from and how it was caught or farmed. So I've also got some questions when I give this advice, like what do I do if I don't know what to do with the answer I get? But in many cases, I think asking is half the battle. So if the place you're buying or ordering fish from does not have the answer, or they're not sure and they're not willing to find out for you, then that's an indicator that they may not be making informed buying decisions or factoring the environment into those decisions. If they do know, or they point to their corporate commitment even better or policy, that's a good sign that they're working on incorporating the environment into those buying decisions. Another thing that you can look for is an eco label or something that says that the seafood has been certified as sustainably caught or farmed. And also think about the gear that's catching the fish. So even though you might not know a lot about different fishing gear, if you saw Lena and I's video last week, we talked about bycatch and how a net can entangle lots of different animals when targeting certain animals, but a hook and a line might be a little bit more selective in targeting those animals.
Lena, do you have any more advice about voting?
Something that you can do right now to help protect the ocean is vote. And every day decisions are being made at all levels of government, from the local level all the way to the national level, that affect the ocean and the animals that live there. And voting gives us the power to choose leaders that make the decisions to protect our oceans, our air, our water. They can choose to conserve the natural places and wildlife that we love, and they ensure that your community has a voice. So you can join us in being a voice for the ocean by visiting voteforTheOcean.org, which is a nonpartisan website where you can check your voter registration status. You can get information such as your polling place location that'll help you make a plan to go vote. You can make and share your pledge to be a voice for the ocean, and you can sign up to get a reminder to vote on election day. If you voted already, awesome job. Remember to check in with three friends to make sure that you all have a plan to vote. The other 364 days a year that aren't election day, you can continue to be a voice for the ocean by reminding your policymakers and other elected officials that the ocean, sustainable fisheries and aquaculture, and the environment are important issues to you. You can also remember to stay informed and engaged on issues affecting your local communities, and check the aquarium's website for other ways that you can get involved. A lot of times we'll have sign-on letters and postcards that you can send your elected officials on different issues that affect the ocean and the environment.
Great. So as a reminder, that was to buy seafood from a purveyor who has a stated sustainable seafood policy, and to ask questions at the point of sale, raise the issue and increase awareness that these issues are around sustainable seafood matter, and that you want the person that you're buying it from to be doing some of the heavy lifting and bringing you more responsible seafood over time, and to cast your vote and towards protecting the blue planet, and to look at things like the aquarium social media feeds for opportunities to get involved and lend your voice.
The most important thing is to not feel guilty if you're not doing any of these things already, or if you think that they're going to be really hard or difficult or scary. Just the fact that you're considering sustainability, you're thinking about maybe where your food is coming from a little bit more, you're looking for ways to get involved and start taking some steps to protect the ocean. Those are all really good steps, and you should be proud of yourself. We're really proud of you. You know, just try to keep it up, and don't stress too much about it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching these videos. We hope you learned a little bit.